market news Wednesday. The Fed left rates unchanged as expected. This was the last meeting for Janet Yellen, our Fed chair. Jeremy Powell was elected as new chair. The Fed upgraded the economy and said that the future rate hikes were warranted. Additionally, they said employment has been rising at the solid rate, and they believe inflation will move up this year. Mortgage bonds dropped after the release, likely in reaction to the Fed thinking inflation would pick up. So it was a crazy week for mortgage interest rates. In economic news, initial job claims, which measures individual filing for unemployment benefits for the first time, showed that there were 230,000 claims last week. This represented a drop of 1,000 from the previous report and was 5,000 better than estimates of 235,000. And for the Seattle real estate market, I know mortgage rates were crazy, not in a positive way. The real estate market, on the other hand, is crazy in a positive way if you are actually benefiting from the equity position increasing. The Seattle area has now led the nation in home price increase for 15 months in a row, the longest streak for any region since 2001. The mild slowdown in prices increased record in some recent months has already come to an end. The greater Seattle area, the market has grown evenly across all segments. Single-family homes, trade-ups, houses, and luxury homes, starter homes. Nationally, price growth ticked up again to 6.2%, in the highest pace in years. And yet, prices here are still soaring more than twice as fast as the national average. Now, this has been the case for years now. The result, the median single-family home now costs $755,000 in Seattle and $938,000 on the east side. Altogether, the typical house in the metro area, which includes King, Snohomish, and Pierce counties, costs 71% more than during the market low in 2012, and costs are up 20% since the old bubble peak in 2007. I mean, it's just crazy what's happening here in the Seattle market. Now, Seattle's 15-month stretch as the nation's hottest housing market is the longest since San Francisco led the country for 19 months during the dot-com bubble from 1999 to 2001. And, you know, you may ask, is it time for this market to slow down, or that we're going to see a bubble ourselves? And I've got a real estate expert here that's going to talk a little bit more detail what's happening. But just from my perspective on the mortgage side and just seeing what's happened, I mean, there's just nothing that can indicate that we're going to see any improvement in more inventory. So without inventory, the supply and demand, where can our property values go except for continue to increase? So, you know, over the short term, 2, 3, even 5 years, I just don't see an answer. Then we've got the potential of interest rates increasing, which, by the way, this week, 0.5% increase in interest rates. I mean, it was just crazy having contracts coming in and 0.5% more than where it was, you know, last week or the week before. So when interest rates do continue to increase and we get at that 6, 7, 8%, which at some point in time that's going to happen, sellers are not going to want to sell their properties because they're going to be sitting at a high 3, mid 3 range, and they've got so much equity in their property, they can just pull equity out and improve their home. So I don't know. Time will tell when that next bubble is going to hit for us. But in the near future, I definitely do not see that as a risk. So sense of urgency out there. If you're a buyer, and I know the inventory is low, it's a competitive market, crazy, crazy competitive market. I would just say, as your host here for the Money Hour, just don't give up. You will get a home. Just stick with it and keep your eye on the market and be willing to go in at a really competitive level. Coming up next in the Money Hour, residential real estate market update. Rosemary West with Avenue Properties, luxury real estate, right here on 1150 AM KKNW.